Grand Slam, Wikipedia Audio. The Grand Slam was a 22,000 pounds earthquake bomb used by RAF Bomber Command against strategic targets during the Second World War. Known officially as the bomb, medium capacity, 22,000 pounds, it was a scaled-up version of the Tallboy bomb and closer to the original size that the bomb's inventor, Barnes Wallace, had envisaged when he first developed his earthquake bomb idea. It was also nicknamed 10-ton Tess. It was the most powerful non-atomic aerial bomb used in combat until 2017, when a US GBU-43/B Moab was used in a 2017 attack against ISIL forces in Afghanistan. Development. When the success was proved, Wallace designed a yet more powerful weapon. This 22,000 pounds bomb did not reach us before the spring of 1945, when we used it with great effect against viaducts or railways leading to the Ruhr and also against several U-boat shelters. If it had been necessary, it would have been used against underground factories, and preparations for attacking some of these were well advanced when the war ended. On July 18, 1943, work started on a larger version of the Tallboy bomb, which became the Grand Slam. As with the original Tallboy, the Grand Slam's fins generated a stabilizing spin and the bomb had a thicker case than a conventional bomb, which allowed deeper penetration. After the hot molten torpex was poured into the casing, the explosive took a month to cool and set. Like the Tallboy, because of the low rate of production and consequent high value of each bomb, air crews were told to land with their unused bombs on board rather than jettison them into the sea if a sortie was aborted. After release from the Avro Lancaster B.Mk1 bomber, the Grand Slam would reach near supersonic speed, approaching 1,049 feet/s, 715 miles per hour. When it hit, it would penetrate deep underground before detonating. The resulting explosion could cause the formation of a camouflage and shift the ground to undermine a target's foundation. Unlike Tallboy, Grand Slam was originally designed to penetrate concrete roofs. Consequently, it was more effective against hardened targets than any existing bomb. The first Grand Slam was tested at the Ashley Range in the New Forest, on March 13, 1945. By the end of the war, 42 Grand Slams had been dropped on active service. Beginning in March 1946, Project Ruby was a joint Anglo-American project to investigate the use of penetration bombs against heavily protected, concrete targets. The target selected was the Valentine submarine pens, that had been rendered unusable and abandoned since 617 Squadron's attack on March 27, 1945. Grand Slams were carried by Lancasters from No. 15 Squadron RAF and U.S. Boeing B-29 Superfortress. Around 140 sorties were flown, testing a range of different bombs including the rocket-assisted Disney bomb. Five complete Grand Slam bombs are preserved and displayed in the United Kingdom at the RAF Museum, London, Brooklands Museum, RAF Lossiemouth, Dumfries and Galloway Aviation Museum and the Battle of Britain Memorial Flight Visitors Centre at RAF Coningsby. Main portions of these bombs, without their lightweight tails, can be seen at the Kelham Island Museum in Sheffield and Yorkshire Air Museum at Elvington. The T-14 bomb is an American-made variant of the Grand Slam. One is displayed at the Air Force Armament Museum in the United States. Grand Slam Combat Operations. Post-war operations. Survivors. Notes. General.